These skill bars right here, well, they're mine in real life. Despite this, I'm trying to make a game and learn about everything that goes into it. I've spent a lot of time here in the past few videos, and a little bit here, but now it's time to put some focus here. I decided to try out LMMS since it's free and open source, and it would also allow me to create some 8-bit sounding audio, which I think would fit really nicely into my game. I haven't used it before this, but I found that messing around with the different sounds was really entertaining. I eventually came across this plugin here that I thought was especially useful. It looks like it's able to randomize presets of a few different game-like sounds, like money and jumping sounds. I don't have any jumping in my game, but I do have coins. After messing around with it a little, I was able to use it to help me make a few different sound effects. Like when you collect a coin, when you shoot a laser, when you buy an item, when your shield gets deactivated, and finally, when you blow up. Oh, and you might have noticed the new rotating shield around the player. Just a small visual upgrade. This is great and all, but the game still feels pretty dead without music. One hobby that I have is I've been trying to learn the piano. I'm by no means a composer, though. In fact, I've never composed anything. The amount of music theory that I know is, well, this much. I do know some chords, I know what keys are, and I've memorized how to play a few songs from their sheet music, but making my own music is new territory for me, so we're going to see how this goes together. First, I started off with making music for the main menu. I'm using my keyboard as a MIDI controller, and I'm just trying things out. I spent a while messing around with different chord progressions and styles until I eventually found something that I liked. Here's the very first song that I made. And it keeps looping. Yeah, it's pretty short, and there isn't much to it beyond a stylized chord progression, but it took me a surprising amount of time to come up with those 6 seconds of music. But I think that's all I needed to gain a little bit of confidence. It's super simple, but after hopping back over to Godot and creating an audio stream player node, my game now has music. It's only on the main menu, but still. Next, I was messing around in the key of A major and stumbled onto something that sounded just depressing enough that I thought it would fit nicely as part of the game over screen. I liked this key because of how it sounds, and also I thought it was fitting, being the first letter of the alphabet and this being my first game. Another song added. Now we need a song for when you're actually playing the game. This took a while because I knew if it was too tough to listen to, it would completely destroy the fun out of the rest of the game. I spent a lot of time trying to find something that I liked. Here's just a small fraction of me doing exactly that. Eventually, though, I settled on a bass line. Then, after a while of more trial and error, I eventually came up with this. Thank you. It's not going to be winning any awards, but I'm pretty happy with it considering the whole no experience thing. Now we just have one more part of the game that still needs music, the shop. I'll spare you some of the mashing on the keyboard until I found something that I liked, but something about this one just felt like it fit. Now that we have audio, I think we can finally add some sliders into the settings menu. While I'm doing that, I can't help but think that the game just feels more complete, even if there's still more that I want to add. Video game music is something that I've always been drawn to. Much like music in movies, there's something about attaching it to another piece of art that allows for emotional connections to be drawn. Take any of the Pokemon or Zelda music from my childhood, for instance. If I had never played those games and I heard the music from it, I'm sure I would like the sound of them. I mean, they sound great, especially considering their limitations in hardware. But I'm not sure I would have spent as much time as I have listening to covers of the songs on YouTube and even looking up sheet music for them. I was there, exploring Kanto and Hyrule while listening to these songs, and those memories I have are attached to the music that I've heard on repeat for hours and hours. This, to me, is majestic in a way. How the combination of separate art forms can come together and create not just a game, but core memories and connections. And if I keep learning, maybe I'll be able to create this for someone else too.